We all know that one of the most useful tools for DIY electronics is the sorterless breadboard. But getting a good quality breadboard is more important than initially thought. I started with a cheap breadboard thinking the quality would not really matter, but I just got a lot of frustration dealing with unreliable connections, struggling in certain components, and a few other issues. I later tried well-known brands, but still encountered problems, so I've been trying different brands ever since, spending more money in the search for the best, and I want to share my findings. I bought all these breadboards with my own money, and I didn't receive anything to support any particular brand, so my opinions are unbiased. The main thing that I search for in a breadboard is having good connections. It's very frustrating trying to test a circuit and getting inconsistent voltage or intermittent connection. Especially when using thin pins, a good connection is almost impossible to achieve with bad quality breadboards. Another thing is that it must be easy to install components. The cheapest breadboards have a narrow funneling that difficult installing components, sometimes even missing the connector altogether. Many cheap breadboards have their power rails split in the middle or even in three parts, forcing us to put jumpers, which I find annoying and unnecessary. Another sign to recognize a bad quality breadboard is when the labels on one side doesn't match the other, which can be confusing. Also, the numbers should align with the holes correctly. Most breadboards come with a double-sided adhesive on the bottom so you can choose to place it on a board, but in my opinion it should also come with a backplate that you can install if you plan to use it as a standalone breadboard. If you use it without any support, the sticky will come off when inserting components. Some models include the backplate, others don't. Also, the backplate should have the correct size so it doesn't block the connection point used to lock multiple breadboards. I sometimes want to join two breadboards momentarily and the backplate prevents me from doing it. Good quality breadboards leave space for that. The sticky should be strong and durable or this will happen over time. And finally, the last thing I consider to judge the quality of a breadboard is the type of connection points to join multiple breadboards. I've seen two types and in my opinion both work well, but most breadboards allow locking other breadboards in only two sides, while ideally it should support in any direction. This is not a big deal, but still something to consider. So now let's go through each brand and model that I bought to see how they compare. I know there are many sizes, but I focus on the standard 830-point breadboard. In order from worst to best, first is the cheapest breadboard I could find on eBay from China. I spent less than $2 with free shipping, so I'm not surprised it failed on every aspect I could think of. The connections are horrible, the labels are a joke, and it's just garbage. Do yourself a favor and stay away from them. A brand that I wanted to try is Adafruit because it's well known, but sadly I got a similar experience. It's so bad that the spacing of the studs are a bit off compared to all the breadboards I have, so it's impossible to attach them. Honestly, just a waste of money. The third in my list is the Elegoo, which I saw on Amazon at $10 for three breadboards, and I thought that because it had good reviews, it was going to be decent. But I was wrong. They have dodgy connections, don't come with a backplate, and overall it feels cheap. It's simply a terrible product that you should better avoid. In fourth, we have the Miyako USA that is very common in some countries, but even though it came with a backplate, the rest is basically the same story with bad connections, split power rails, and nonsense labels. Skip this one even if it's on sale. Next on my list is the Jameco Valuepro BB-102 that at least achieved good connections, but it lacks a backplate and sometimes it's a bit hard to install components. One day I even bent one of the connectors trying to insert a jumper wire, so I don't really recommend it. At a similar price, I later tried the breadboard from Busboard Prototype Systems, and let me tell you that it has been working pretty well in the few months I've been using it. I later bought the transparent version too, which also works great, although I prefer the conventional color. I have only two small complaints though. The backplate is very thin, especially compared to the other ones I tested. And you can't connect breadboards in this direction. But the rest is perfectly fine. So far, this is the best breadboard I could find for the lowest price. The last on my list, meaning is the best in my opinion, is the Jameco Valuepro WBU-202R. Surely it's a bit better with the option to stack breadboards in any direction, with a great backplate, and is the heaviest of all the breadboards I tested. But at almost double the price compared to the previous one, I'm not sure it's worth the extra money. Maybe it's going to last longer, or who knows? If you want the highest quality breadboard, so far this is the best I've tried. One thing that I noticed is that there seems to be some relation between the weight of the breadboard without the backplate and the quality, with the heaviest being the best, and apparently most of the weight difference comes from the metal on the connectors. Strangely enough, the lightest breadboard that I tested is the Busboard Prototype Systems that I recommended. It makes me wondering if it's going to be as durable as the heaviest breadboard. So those are my recommendations, and let me know if there are other brands at this price range that I should consider too. If I find other good brands, I will include them on the description. That's it for now, and see you in the next video. Bye bye!